This right here is called the Ark, and this is the definition of ultimate. Now, why would I say that? Well, the Ark has six reasons right here, which is a smart hub, long-range router, entertainment center, energy management, smart firewall, and a live TV. The specs. And all this weighs a little bit over than 2 pounds. Check out the link so you can get more details. So let's unbox it. Definitely has some weight to it. Quick start guide telling you what to do. Ethernet cable, power cord, and HDMI. We have an AV, one HDMI, two USB ports, super audio, Ethernet hookup, two LAN ports for wired connection, an SD card reader, and a hard drive disk. Next to the DC power, and we have a reset. So here is the hard drive. This will allow us to store as much as we want. That is super cool. And lastly, the remote. We got some brightness, we got security camera, we got the home buttons, there's a mouse clicker so you can use this as a mouse, the microphone, and then the microphone's right down here. The keyboard has a really soft touch to it, and if you want to open it, just bring that out. And nice use of space. You can see the batteries are actually not included. So the next thing to do is hook this up to my TV. Let's go check it out. As you can see, the Ark is on my right side. Take the first step towards smart living. So you can see I can navigate up and down through different languages. It's really easy and familiar. Plug in the provider Ethernet cable into WAN. You have to make an Ark account. Once you get past that, there's an application for iPhone and Android. This is the app. We're going to press get. Once it's done with that, you'll go next. Configuring apps, please wait. This does do a mouse mode while that's doing that thing. You can see that as I point around, this actually moves the mouse. That is cool. And if you press on the home button, this is the home. We get the correct date on the top left. And then there's an X right next to it. That's to kill all the applications running in the background. There's the do not disturb or your notification stuff. So you can see a lot of notification happening there. Of course, you can turn it into the mouse mode so you can scroll right through it and touch and bring it up. So yeah, if you hold on to it, very fluid. It seems like it's running pretty fast. Clicking on the Bluetooth will bring up Bluetooth so we can see what's connected to the remote. Obviously, we can connect other keyboards, whatever other devices, speakers you want to plug into it. Then if we click on to this world button, so this is giving us a router information. There's nothing in the background running or downloading. And then here's the Wi-Fi setting. So we're creating a Wi-Fi signal. So you'll name it something and then create a password. Wi-Fi modes. So you can see in the green, it's telling you how far the signal is. And if you want to go long range, it'll extend a lot longer. So if you can reach more devices, this is going to be helpful for that. You can turn it off so you don't have to use Wi-Fi at all, or just have every other devices just not use Wi-Fi. So you can choose when people can use it. Sleep mode is basically just within you, so no one else can get it and you don't have to turn anybody else off, just whoever is in that little closer area. So that's nice to see. But standard mode is what I would be using for now. So how this will work is that you connect your Ark to your modem, so you connect it wired, or if you want to use this Ark because it works better with Wi-Fi and it tells you what's going on in it. It just has everything built into one thing. We're gonna log in, go into Wi-Fi, the Wi-Fi that we just made. So I just connected to that. So you can see Alberto's iPhone is showing right on the screen. There's nothing on my phone that's taking data, but if I click on YouTube and I start playing a video, it's gonna start showing on the screen. That's the download speed and the upload speed that it's taking. So you can see how many users are online, the iPhone. So if I connect another device, I'd be able to control it. So if I go over to Alberto's iPhone, do you want to add this device to blacklist? But that's how easy it is. I literally created my own Wi-Fi router connection here using this Ark. It's going to be super easy to manage and see what's working through. So if you don't want to buy a Google Wi-Fi router, or your normal modem doesn't come with one of these little settings, or you don't know how to use it, intelligent bands. So you can see you can prioritize it. Prioritizing things makes your speed go fully to whatever you're using, and things will still be in the background taking the internet, but everything will be just mostly for whatever device you're trying to run. Old modified router password, router state tells you success and web guide, all that kind of information. So let's go back out of that. So that's what the world does. And if you click on the cog here in the settings, there's Ark settings and you'll get into more stuff. So we don't really need to go much through there. Now, if you click on the all apps, so all these apps here are preloaded. Google Play is here. So what we're gonna do is go into the cog, go to add device. Then you get a message like this and you just registered the product. And just like that, we're going to agree. And the last step is to power on and off the Ark. And once it's up and running again, you are ready to move on to the Play Store. So now when we go to our apps, we can see Google Play. Click on that. and we're launching the Google Play. So now we have the whole entire app store here. So the apps and game possibility is endless. Update all your apps through here. Let's download Happy Glass. And your mouse pointer here is your finger touches. So press start. And obviously it'll depend on the game if you can use the mouse pointer and or if it supports a remote control. That's up to the app developer. And or you can find an emulator app that you might be able to customize with a gaming controller. But simple clicking games like this you can use, obviously. So YouTube, all this preloaded, all the main stuff that you need to use to run. So let's just kind of bring this down and navigate. So here we go. Let's bring out the mouse and see how it's all working. No issues, no problem, no stuttering. I have not seen anything weird happening here. What's going on there? They're just nonchalant eating. It's just a normal day for them, I see. That's funny. That chicken doesn't want to not walk into the concrete. Okay, anyways, let's back out of it. So YouTube is working nicely. Again, everything feels so fluid running this. And check out the sections that we have. So we got all apps, right? Go to the movie section. So you get movie. So if we go over, we can see more movies that are loading. So there's a preview and it gives you sources of where to watch it. iTunes, Vudu, Microsoft. You see what's happening there. So you can sign into these accounts, kind of like a host to all your other accounts, TV shows down here. Now, so again, this is going to just show you what type of shows you can watch. And if you go into the certain seasons or the pilot, then it's going to give you the host hosting of wherever your account is. All in one system, if you have multiple different ways of watching HBO, Showtime, different accounts, you get the idea how that works. Live TV, so if you click on live TV, we're gonna accept that, of course. This is literally live TV right now. This is on Australia. We wanna go into Canada if you want to. You can see what's happening there. Let's see, Italy, you can see all those others. United States, let's go to United States. So you're not gonna be able to rewind or skip, this is live TV. That's the point of being able to get. You can always download more channels. So you're gonna be able to do more tinkering around, as you can see. So yeah, let's go to smart home. So the smart home, if you have smart devices that this can connect to, it'll tell you all the energy, what it's using, the router download speed. So you can see the memory information, security, so you can lock stuff. So that is a pretty much user interface of what's happening here. I think it's pretty cool. There's a lot more things here, smart living. So the latest news from MetroCon. So if you want to learn more about it, get more accessories, tutorials, this is just pretty much telling you the gist of what it does and what it can do. Add all your favorites. And the other one is Showbox. And once you have them selected there, we can click on Showbox and we get all these movies for free. So you can use the navigation arrow to point and click on things. Like click on the menu. We go to TV shows. And you can see here that we got all these shows. So let's click on the flash. You can see all the little thumbnails of pictures. You will have to click back and forth through the arrows. And you can see you can select different seasons. So if we go season 3, let it load. And we're going to have to move all the way down. And you can see that there's more here. Spoilers, sorry, if you're going to be watching the show and going to see a little piece of it. And you can see that we're getting the whole entire movie that you would normally watch on Netflix for Frilla. I am making a dedicated video on this application, but you already know what it can do, what it does. You can watch everything in one little system. This is one of the best hubs that I've seen that has so much things that you can do. Obviously, you don't have to go through all those third-party pirating apps. You can do it through here so you get even better quality. Rather than waiting on an app like Cartoon HD or Showbox that sometimes works or doesn't. So that's that. Everything you know and don't know that Android offers can be done on the MetroCom. With patience, tweaks, and tutorials, this is truly an all-in-one ultimate device here. So there you guys have it. What do you think? If you want one of these all-in-one hubs with the capabilities of everything that I showcased here and more that I don't even have accessories that you're going to have to discover and take advantage of, you already know what to do. As always, find it in the description down below, and I will see you guys next time. Later.